people.
Mercury radial engine. The first Blenheims were delivered in Mark 1 form to No. 114 Squadron at Witten near Huntingdon in March 1937. And such was its performance that potential was seen to create a long-range fighter version with a ventral gun pack of 4.303 Browning machine guns. And it's in that configuration of the Blenheim 1F, F for fighter, that we see this aircraft today. Production switched in 1939 to the long-nosed Blenheim 4, which came into use just before the outbreak of World War II. When war was declared on the 3rd of September 1939, there were more Blenheims in RAF service, nearly 1,100 of them, than any other single aircraft type, and the first operational RAF actions of the war all involved Blenheim 4s. Squadron aircraft from Witten that became the first British aircraft to overfly Germany after the start of the war on a reconnaissance sortie. The following day, the 4th of September, aircraft of numbers 107 and 110 squadrons from Wattisham carried out Bomber Command's first raid on the hostilities. They went on that day to attack the German fleet in port at Wilhelmshaven. Their losses were grievous because such had been the pace of aircraft development that what had been a high-performance type only a few years earlier was now outmoded. And it's because of the heroism against the odds shown by Blenheim crews that it's so important that this one has been kept flying. Thank you.
probably what is looking at, what it needs, your measurable position, measurable current, so it's a little bit distribution of this. So it's a ты вырастешь и будешь.
On the 4th of July 1941, number 105 Squadron mounted a very hazardous daylight raid on the German port of Bremen under the leadership of Wing Commander Huey Edwards. Spellbinding display from John in the Bristol Glenn. So what we have here in the Gladiator is an aircraft that achieved two milestones in RAF history above all. The first RAF fighter to enter service with an enclosed cockpit, which it did in February 1937, but also the RAF last new biker fighter. Earlier of the Royal Aircraft Factory, but joined officers. By the time it developed its new SS-37 design as a private venture evolution of its earlier gauntlet, but because the RAF's new monoplane fighters, the Hurricane and the Spitfire, were quite significantly delayed, the RAF decided to take this on as an interim measure. War broke out. Two of them in 1939. German fighters in May 1940, all was lost within 10 days. But this wasn't to say that this was an unsuccessful airplane, quite the reverse. Gladiators claimed the kills of 26 Luftwaffe aircraft during the attempts to defend Norway against German invasion in early 1940. Thank you. and in Malta, naval-eyed sea gladiators flown by pilots of both the RAF and the Fleet Air Arm put up a dogged defence that same year. Let's running in to take its place on display now. Headed by Teddy Petter, who went on to join English Electric and gain great fame there for the likes of the Canberra and the Lightning.
Это может у них был и напокрыл. Вот мы покрыл вот крыло. Как закрыл, он будет под вами. Как и гарно. И дивись, как он близко было пошло.
Я знаю.
Дивись, как он близко было пошло.
Meet a specification for a new army cooperation aircraft. This became the first monoplane to serve with the RAF's Army Cooperation Command. This high-wing monoplane with huge undercarriage spats, plenty of cockpit glazing for the pilot and the observer. They served in the Western Desert, in Greece and the Far East. Most famously, they served not far from here with numbers 138 and 161 squadrons at Newmarket and Tempsford, supporting the Special Operations Executive and completing more than 400 operations to aid the SOE between August 1941 and the end of 1944. And they were Lysanders configured like this one, with an access ladder and a long-range fuel tank, dropping agents into Nazi-occupied Europe and recovering them from behind enemy lines, flying into and out of small landing sites at night, lit by nothing more than moonlight and a few torches that might have been put there to mark out the strip by members of the French Resistance. This one of two Lysanders airworthy in the UK. The other one, which we've also had here in the past, is with the Aircraft Restoration Company at Duxford. And a very spirited account of Shuttleworth's Lizzie given to us today by Peter Cockburn.